and it tells them what they're going to do. And ye shall be witnesses unto me. And he told them where, amen, they would be witnesses. Amen. I just want to note right there, amen, that the power that we have received, those of us that have been so blessed to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit, amen, the power, amen, was not given to us just for the sake of jumping over pews, amen, dancing, amen, across the floors, flipping over benches, amen, and just, you know, exhibiting a lot of joyful demonstrations, because we seem to think that having done these things that we've really had church, and if we have not done it, we have not really had church. But I just want to submit to you that we can do all of that and still haven't had church.
Amen.
Because see, when you really have a church is when souls are saved. People are filled with the Holy Ghost. Signs and wonders are performed. Amen. In other words, we see God in action. Amen. And this is one particular book in which the Holy Spirit is being featured as he moves in and through the believer. It's named Acts of the Apostles, but it's actually the Acts of the Holy Spirit through the apostles. Amen. And we can see, amen, that the Holy Spirit had came more to do some executing of the power of God rather than what we call joyful demonstration. Amen. That only profits you.
Yes.
Because bodily exercise profit, come on now, profit and live, amen? And so those things that we do, they're responses, amen, that we have. And certainly the Word of God in Psalms, amen, tells us how to respond, amen, to the greatness of God, to the goodness of God, to all of the attributes of God and everything there is about God. It gives us, you know, some kind of understanding as to how we should respond to that. Amen. And so we respond accordingly, but yet it does not show God moving. The only time we see the movement is when God begins to inhabit our praise, and then we begin to see the execution of the power.
Yes.
Glory to God. Yes. When the power of God moves, God doesn't need anybody to do anything. Yes. He can do it all by himself. Oh, come on now. Have I got a witness tonight? Yes. Glory to God. But here, Peter and John, and the emphasis that I wanted to make, amen, in this particular text, amen, is that Peter and John were going up to the temple together. Somebody say together.
Together.
Amen. There is so much disunity and discord, amen, in the body of Christ.
Amen.
And I think one of the things that we need to learn, which is my first part, is that we're on the same team. Somebody say that,
well,
we're on the same team.
We're on the same team.
Look at somebody and tell them we're on the same team.
We're on the same team.
If we're in the body of Christ, amen. Now, I can understand if we're not, amen. But if we're in the body of Christ, amen. Now, this little understanding that some people have, well, we are all children of God. No, we're not. Amen. Some of us are children of the devil.
Yes.
Say
it.
That ye are of your
father, the devil.
Glory to God. But there are those of us, amen, that believed on him. And according to John 1 and 12, but to as many as received him, to them gave he power to become. Now, power there is the right or the privilege. Come on here. Amen. They have been given the right or the privilege to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. So those that have done so They are the children of God. Oh, come on now. So if we all have done that, then we are all on the same team. Now maybe we have been planted in different vineyards. Oh, come on now. And then in that planting, God knew, amen, the stages of development. Hallelujah. So mindful of us and who we are and our uniqueness, he knew that every ministry could not minister to everybody. Just because number two didn't holler like number one. So now you're going to be bored with number two. And see, while you being bored, the word for your deliverance, the word for your breakthrough, you're missing it altogether. Because you were dealing with the surface. But God, hallelujah, is sending the word for your very life. And you need to forget about what's on the outside. And you need to listen to God.
Chosen. I'm just glad to be chosen.
then I'm not jealous of you, and I'm not envious of you and what you've been called to do, because you need my part so you can do your part. Glory to God. And see, when you're comfortable and you're confident, hallelujah, in where you've been placed, hallelujah, nobody even have to call your name. They don't never have to call your name. You don't have to be listed in the list of who's who. Oh, come on here. And then they gained your name out of the souvenir journal. Amen. You're not upset. You're not upset. You're not upset, because the thing about it is, you know you were there. Change. That's all I care about. I have fulfilled my mission. Thank the Lord. He knows my name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So here's Peter and John. Amen. Obviously, this was something that they already had under their belt, this knowledge. Amen. No, didn't seem that there was any competition. Glory to God, and competing with one another. Amen. But they were together. Somebody say together. They were together. And they're going into the temple at the hour of prayer. Amen. I'd like to say that they were on time. Amen. They were on time. Ain't nobody gonna help me. They were on time for prayer. Glory to God. Amen. And they went up together. Amen. But as they were going in, they see the lame man. Amen. Now, he was no stranger to them. Amen. They were familiar with him because he's been there. Yeah. Amen. Daily. Every day. For years. Yeah. Amen. As a matter of fact, this was, you would call his employment. Hallelujah. His job was being in that temple. Hallelujah. Asking for alms. Hallelujah. Amen. So he'd been doing that. Amen. For years, everybody was familiar with him, and everybody knew he wasn't playing as far as his condition was concerned, because the scripture doesn't give us any indication that he was playing. Amen. He was the real deal. Amen. Because, you know, we got phonies out here. You know, they can't walk and all that. You're having mercy, and then the little lady, you might see the same person walking down the street passing you. But this wasn't the case. Amen. But I just thought it just a wonderful thing, amen, to see how they operated together. Amen. Peter did not, even though we see Peter at times seemingly taking the lead, amen, but it looked like, amen, it appeared that, amen, John was being in the supportive role to Peter. Amen. But Peter did not negate John, because he said, look on us. He said, look on us. So, amen. So he wanted the lame man to pay attention to the both of them. Now, I don't know. Amen. I can only speculate here. But perhaps, amen, both of them had it in their spirit, the words of Jesus that said, if any two of you shall agree, come on, that's touching anything that they shall ask, hallelujah, it shall be done for them by the Father which is in heaven. So they seem to be in agreement. It doesn't seem that they had a discussion before Peter started talking. Glory to God. So obviously, amen, so the man got their attention, and together they were in agreement that something good is going to happen to them. Hallelujah. Glory to God. No doubt they were excited about this power that they had on the inside, and they were ready, amen, to execute it. Let me tell you something. When this power within you is generating right, you can't help but release it. Glory to God, you release it somehow. I don't know, sometimes it's on the train. Come on here. Hallelujah. Just might be touching somebody. Y'all know here. Hallelujah. They may not fall out and be slain in the spirit, but there is a transfer. Hallelujah. anointing on this man, realizing that this situation is not impossible. It's not impossible. Yeah, the facts are there. This man born like this, been like this all these years. And they both were on or with one accord in understanding that no matter what the facts are, you heard it today, the truth is God is a healer.
Yes.
And he can heal this man. And he can heal him now. Hallelujah. So please look on us. The man thought he was going to get something. Oh, y'all must be going to tip me real good because everybody else be going in. They might throw something in there and keep on moving under the prayer. But they still stand there and say, you must got some big money to be dropping up in here. So, yeah, I'll give you all the attention you need. How much of my attention do you want? And you got it. Then Peter makes his announcement. Silver and gold. Y'all not going to work with me. Silver and gold. That's what I'm looking for, you know. Silver and gold have I none. Well, I mean, if it was some of us, we'd say, now what you stand for? Do you know I might have missed $100 just walking up in the temple? And you're going to stop me? You got all my attention, and now that you got my attention, you're going to tell me that you're broke. But then he continues to talk and says, such as I am, I'm going to give that to you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. He didn't even leave room for a thought. He said, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, get up and walk.
Hallelujah.
And he spoke with the power of God. Oh, come on here. The power of God surrounded and enveloped the man. And then he was able to take that right hand and transfer what was in him into the man. And the Bible said, immediately. Oh, don't take God on me. Immediately. Help me say immediately. How many know God will work immediately? It's not all the time that you got to wait for a period of time. There's some times that God will move. So he did the hardest thing.
Amen.
First. He leaped.
Yes.
He leaped. But remember, he ain't never stood. So he didn't only stand, but he leaped. Then he walked.
Standing.
He saw himself. And the Bible says that he was praising God. As we read in the text of how John was right there. Peter was doing most of the talking, but John was right there supporting. Beloved, it takes us together. Hallelujah. Glory to God. To understand that we are one dynamic, powerful force in this earth. We are the representatives of him. We are Christ in the earth. Come on here. And the enemy has us now, hallelujah, divided on issues that really don't matter.
Yes.
as opposed to seeing it for what it is. It's the enemy trying to deter the church from being the church that it is to be in the earth, and especially in this hour. So we need to stop majoring in the minors. The Bible had already told us to avoid endless genealogies and all kinds of discussions that don't amount to anything. What we need to do is fight this adversary
that's
coming against us, and we are the ones that are the salt of the earth. We are the ones that are holding this earth in place. Without us, the earth would be destroyed.
Yes.
We're the ones that's holding it together. We're the ones, hallelujah, that are preserving the earth from destruction. And it's time for us, amen, to stop fighting one another and fight our real and common enemy. And that is the devil. Oh, come on here. In our school systems, in our government. Oh, come on. In our neighborhoods, in our communities. Come on now. In our families. Glory to God. These things, amen, are happening all over the place. Popping up here, popping up there. And the question has been, where is the church?
Where is the church?
Where are we at? I'll tell you where we at.
Yes.
And we run around and we speaking in tongues to one another. I wish I had help. But we're not opening our mouths and declaring the counsel of God. We seem to be afraid to do that. But then I'm trying to understand, well, what do you have the Holy Ghost for? Don't nobody want to shout now? What do you have the Holy Ghost for? Well, he's a keeper. Hallelujah. All right, and he kept you to do you're preserved for.
Yes.
And when you get done with all that, then.
Yes.
Jesus said, I must work the works of him that sent me.
Yeah.
While it is day. And you must. Got quiet right quick. There is a responsibility that we have as the church of Jesus Christ. And what God wants to do by the Holy Spirit is to bring us into that at one moment that we need to be putting aside the things that don't matter and being able to understand each other, appreciate one another, appreciate our diversities, and learn how to love all one another, and appreciate the fact that maybe you're not where I am and maybe I'm not where you are, but together we'll get where we need to be. Oh, come on. Hallelujah. I'm not prejudiced against you because you don't apply the word as I do. But I love you just the same. You're my brother. You're my sister. And together we're able to accomplish this or that. Let's combat the enemy and not each other. And sometimes we can be within the same local congregation and we're combating each other. Why they leave my cake and eat everybody else? What's wrong with my cake? I stayed up all night doing it. I'm sick of these folks in this church. They're always not eating my cake. Oh, come on now. Who made the potato salad? Oh, come on here. Whether it be a miracle or whether people will look at you like, really? And you want me to do what? I don't see that. And today, it's just that break. amazing. They'll tell you. I'm seeing the consistency between what you say and what you do. So we want to check ourselves. Somebody say, check yourself. You would want to check yourself and make sure that since you are a part of this body, you want to make sure that your spot, because that's the spot that you're responsible for. You want to make sure that your spot is together. I want to make sure that I'm right. So when the checkers come through, when the checker comes through, come on, when they check mine, my space is good. Anybody want to make sure your space is good? I want to make sure I'm right in the right space, in the right mindset, with the right attitude.
Yes.
So that I can be effective, and that this power that I have received in the Holy Ghost is not just generating in me. It's just doing nothing. It's just turning over in me. And it's not released to where it could be effective and change the very course of somebody's life. Amen?
Amen.
I think it's praying time.
Amen.
Because I didn't want you to shout. I want you to say.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because we have to tone down some shouting. Not all of it. But we have to tone down some, amen, because we need to be able to sit and hear, and then we need to do something about that. And we need to understand, no matter how long you've been saved. No matter how long you've been saved, you want to make sure on the inside, am I part of the problem or am I part of the solution?